On the morning of June 7, 2023, at 4:44 a.m. local time, a body of lava burst through the caldera floor of Kilauea, starting a new eruption. This video clip, courtesy of the U.S. Geological Survey, displays the eruption's first few moments. Lava fountains during the initial moments initially shot to a height of 153 meters or 502 feet. Several seconds later, fragments of molten rock fell back to the ground, where they began flowing towards lower sections of the caldera floor. Lava fountains soon were reduced to a height of less than 10 meters or 33 feet, but over time, additional fissures and scattered new vents opened up on the crater floor. By an hour later, what I estimate to be a square kilometer of the caldera floor had already been covered in glowing orange lava. For some context, the Kilauea volcano is the youngest and most active of the four active volcanoes which make up the Big Island of Hawaii. Since 1900, Kilauea has erupted more than 50 times, with there being about a 55% chance it was actively erupting at any point since then. Just like the ongoing eruption, the vast majority of these recent eruptions occurred within the summit caldera of Kilauea, called Halemaumau. This caldera last expanded during 2018 when a flank eruption caused magma to drain away from the caldera, triggering a collapse. Luckily, there is currently no indication that the erupting lava will drain away and travel elsewhere on the island. Thus, those of you in Pohoa and Leilani Estates in the East Rift Zone, or those of you who like to hike along the Southwest Rift Zone, should feel relatively safe for now. Were a flank eruption to occur, it would be preceded by a sudden drop in lava levels at Halemaumau Crater, along with a series of earthquakes which would track along the magma's path before it erupted. Currently, lava is being exclusively emitted within the caldera and will likely remain there for the duration of the eruption. Although the rate of lava fusion may have peaked at around a rate of 20 cubic meters per second, in my opinion, it has probably decreased already to less than 7 cubic meters per second. Regardless, this eruption, in my opinion, is almost completely safe to view, as there is no explosive component to it, as no ash has been generated, meaning it would be rated on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a zero. Yet, due to the abundant lava Kilauea is emitting, it is also producing something else, a series of gases and aerosols which includes sulfur dioxide, with the amount of released gas roughly correlating with the amount of erupting or shallow magma. These gases can create what is known as VOG, or volcanic fog, which, if it gets strong enough, can cause negative health effects, especially for those in sensitive groups or those with asthma. Other than VOG, the current eruption of Kilauea does not pose any hazards to nearby towns such as Volcano. Although about half of Kilauea's eruptions since 1900 have lasted a week or less, in my opinion, the current eruption will probably last on the order of 2.5 to 10 months. Kilauea until today had not erupted since March 7th of 2023, and that date marked the end of a 61-day-long eruption. Yet, in comparison, the current eruption seems to initially involve a larger amount of magma. There had been a longer period for Kilauea's shallow magma chamber to recharge since its last eruption, and the ground deformation at its summit had exceeded values produced before the January 2023 eruption by a notable amount. During the current eruption, it is quite likely that the number of active vents and fissures will slowly reduce in number until only one vent is left. This might form a small spatter cone or hornado, and along the way, what are likely to be millions of cubic meters of lava will continue to fill a section of the down drop block left by Kilauea's 2018 eruption. We will know if the current eruption is slowly coming to an end if summit ground subsidence begins on a small scale, which could indicate that the amount of magma intruding into the subsurface is being outweighed by the amount of erupting lava. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.